Is dairy good for you? Should it be part of your diet? Or is dairy really bad for you? Or does it depend on the dairy product involved? With a little bit of science, maybe you will be better placed to make up your own mind. So welcome to ShapeFixer. I'm Andrew. I'm a nutritionist and I'm a biologist. And I actually used to be a science teacher. And in this video, we're going to talk about dairy, what's in it, what is good for you in it, what the risks and the negative sides are, and you can decide, as I said in the introduction, whether or not you want to include any dairy products in your diet. So let's go. Let's talk about dairy and what it is and where it comes from. It's milk. It's milk products. Comes from, traditionally from cows, but it could be from sheep or from goats. And it is baby food. It is cow baby food. It's not really meant for us. Now, that doesn't mean that it's bad for us necessarily, or that we can't use it, but it's certainly not what it was intended for, and you are not a calf. A lot of people use that argument to close their case against dairy and say therefore we shouldn't be eating it, and it's not as simple as that. What is in it? Protein, fats, carbohydrates. It's very, very nutrient rich, so there are lots of nutrients in milk and in milk products that we can use and do use if we eat it, and they're very good for us. There is a lot of sugar in milk. Sugar is not good for us. The sugar in milk is called lactose, which is half glucose and half galactose, which is another type of sugar, and when the two are linked together, that makes lactose. And the glucose half of the milk sugar goes straight into your blood and gives you a blood sugar spike. The galactose, your body can't metabolize galactose, so it has to go to the liver first and be converted to glucose, after which it also goes into your bloodstream. That is the same process when you eat fruit and you absorb fructose or fruit sugar. It goes through the same process as galactose, gets converted to glucose in your liver, and then goes into your bloodstream. And you know what else goes through that process? Alcohol. So processing galactose or fructose in your liver is the same as overloading your liver with alcohol. It's not a healthy process. It's a strain on your liver. You're better off not doing it. So the sugar component of milk is really not worth drinking or consuming. But you can separate milk into its fatty, oily part and the part that is fat-free, essentially, like skimmed milk. So we're going to avoid that. We're not going to use the skimmed milk because that really is where all the sugar is. And now we're going to look at the cream side of the milk, from which we make things like butter and cheese and yogurt. The fats are very good for you. In fact, the fat in butter is mostly what is called a medium-chain triglyceride, which is absorbable immediately through your small intestine without actually having to break it down first. So if you need quick energy from fats, butter is a very good option. If you have had your bile, if you're not producing bile, or you've had your gallbladder removed, so you're not able to digest fats properly, then butter is a really good option. So is coconut oil, for example. But if you're on a carnivore diet, then obviously coconut oil is not something you're going to want to use. So butter is a really good option. The protein in milk is mostly casein. Casein has very essential amino acids in it. We can break down the casein into the amino acids to help build our own proteins. So it is quite a good source of protein. It's not as protein dense as, say, meat, but the proteins in there are perfectly good for us. But some people have other issues with dairy, and this is where it gets a little bit complicated. Some people are lactose intolerant. That means they don't have the enzyme that breaks the lactose sugar into glucose and galactose. They can't actually separate it out, so they can't absorb the sugars. They sit in the gut and they cause an inflammatory response, which often leads to diarrhea. So if you are lactose intolerant, the simple answer is don't drink milk or use any dairy products that still have the milk sugar in them. You'll probably find you're fine with butter and most cheeses. You won't have that reaction, but don't drink milk. Some people claim to have a milk allergy. And what's interesting is when you look up milk allergy, you find that it is a reaction, a sort of hypersensitivity to the casein, which is the protein in the milk. It's not an allergy. It's an intolerance. It's a digestive issue. An allergy triggers your immune system almost immediately, and you have a massive response. You can go into anaphylactic shock, and it can be lethal. This so-called milk allergy, or the intolerance to casein, can take hours or even a day before you react. Well, that's not an allergy then. That's an intolerance because you're unable to digest it properly. You're unable to break the casein down. So that protein, instead of being broken down into its amino acids and absorbed in your stomach, goes all the way through your system where it causes an inflammatory reaction on its way through. The simple answer is then, don't eat it. Because the good news is that even though there are nutrients in milk and in milk products that are very useful in terms of the proteins and the fats in particular, none of them are essential. Okay, you can have a very healthy diet without any dairy whatsoever. The only advantage of dairy, especially if you're on a carnivore diet, is that it does give you a few more options in terms of your variety of food, and it's a nice condiment type of food group to use. I put grated cheese or butter on a lot of my food because I'm not intolerant to lactose. I don't have a casein problem. And so I'm perfectly able to digest it. And so I use it as a condiment. I put a little bit of full fat milk or cream or butter in my coffee, and I put cheese on my food sometimes. So I use dairy. Don't go and drink a glass of milk, because that is just loaded with lactose, which is sugar, but it doesn't taste sweet because it's only fructose that actually tastes sweet. So table sugar tastes sweet because there's fructose in it. Fruit tastes sweet because of the fructose. Some fruit is sweeter than others because it's got more fructose, and then the one that doesn't taste as sweet might have more glucose. So it's still got lots of sugar. Milk is full of sugar. Don't drink it. The last thing I'll say about dairy that you hear a lot is that, oh, it's got growth hormones in it, it's got cow sex hormones in it, and these hormones are going to play havoc in your body because these are not appropriate hormones to be circulating around your system. And you're absolutely right, they are not. But they won't, because they break down in your stomach acid, and by the time you absorb the components of those chemicals, those compounds are not active anymore. So they make no difference to you. If you find that doubtful, or you're worried about that, or you've heard the opposite somewhere else and someone has scared you into avoiding milk because of the growth hormones and because of all the other things that are apparently in the milk, and you don't trust the science, and you don't trust, I don't know, me, and why should you? You don't trust that your stomach acid is strong enough to break them all down, and so they're irrelevant, it's fine. Don't eat it. Simple solution. As I said before, we don't have to eat dairy. It's not an essential part of your diet. So if you have any problems with it at all, lactose intolerant, casein hypersensitivity, or just plain old worry and fear that there are compounds in milk that are not designed for humans, certainly not adult humans, therefore it seems fundamentally wrong to you to be drinking milk, that's fine. Don't drink it. Avoid butter, avoid cheese, avoid cream, avoid yogurt, avoid all the dairy products, and you won't have to worry about whether or not they're going to do any harm. But I can tell you as a scientist that unless you are intolerant or hypersensitive to casein or lactose, then dairy is not going to do you any harm, unless you have too much dairy and you have too much lactose, in which case you'll have the normal issues that are associated with high sugar consumption. Okay, but a bit of cream, a bit of butter, a bit of cheese should, in most cases, be absolutely fine for you. Okay, right, there we go. That's where we are with dairy. Thank you for liking, and thank you for subscribing to our channel. And please stick around to watch more videos, because we never stop making videos here at ShapeFixer.